Hey everyone, today we will talk about how to design a video distribution service. So let's get started. Let's talk about functional requirements. Content Manager should be able to upload video along with its subtitle and thumbnail. A user should be able to watch video without any buffering. User should also be able to search video by title and associated keywords. User should be able to see trending videos and videos of his interest. This platform should be able to sync video playback on all the devices for same user. Now, let's talk about non-functional requirements. The system should be having very low latency. The system should be highly available. Also, the system is supposed to be highly reliable, which means there should be no data loss or no data corruption. Now, let's talk about media upload part. Let's say there are multiple content managers who want to upload video content on this platform. Primarily, they will call media upload and content manager service in order to upload thumbnail, subtitle, and video content. Now, this service would be responsible for storing videos, subtitles, and thumbnails in separate DBs and also would be able to save the mapping of video ID, title, description, author, publish time, thumbnail, video content, and subtitle in the metadata DB. Okay. Now, ideally, we want to upload a file in chunks so that we could resume interrupted upload also. We need not to divide a large video file into chunks on local device physically because our browser side script can calculate MD5 checksum and number of equal sized chunks required before uploading and start uploading each chunk one after another by maintaining next chunk offset in memory. Okay. Also, once video is upload is completed, server can verify the data correctness by computing MD5 again against the MD5 which we computed before uploading the file. Okay. So this is how the upload part works. Okay. Now, once upload is completed, Media Upload and Content Manager service will notify a couple of workers using post upload processing message queue in order to chunk the video into different small chunks, and these chunking is supposed to be based on audio silence. Okay, this means the chunks are not supposed to be equal sized, but mostly the chunks are supposed to be based on the sentences. Okay. Also, there would be some transcoding workers who would be responsible for transporting this video file into multiple resolutions primarily. And there would be a search consumer who would push this data, primarily the title, description, etc., into search DB. Okay. Now, let's say the chunking happens. Okay. After chunking, we will get a lot of chunks for each file. Okay. And again, all these chunks needs to be transcoded into different resolutions. So primarily we will have three subdirectory for each video related folder. So let's say there's one folder which maintains chunks for video number 114. Okay. Which contains three subdirectory, each for different resolutions like 480p, 720p, and 1080p. And all these chunks are stored in these subdirectories primarily. Okay. Once all chunks are stored in different resolutions in separate storage or separate subdirectory, there would be a CDN who would be pulling all this content and making this available over the different geographical locations. Okay. This is how so far the upload and post-upload processing has been done. Okay. Now let's talk about the user side. Okay. Let's say there are three users. Primarily two users. One is logged in user and the other is non-logged in user. Also, logged in user is online on two different devices. One is device X, other is device Y. Okay, all these devices are connected to user side API gateway. Okay, where they can search using a particular title or keyword via video search service, which consumes the search database, which was populated by a search consumer in the previous slide. Okay. Now, let's talk about video serving. Okay. Once we select a particular video, okay, there should be one service who should be responsible for serving video chunks in a sequence. Also, making sure all devices are in sync in terms of seed time. Okay. So let's say on one device, a user has seen a video till 4:30. Automatically on the second device, the seed time will move to 4:30 so that this user can resume the video watching session on second device from that point itself. Okay. How does this happen? Primarily, this service would be making sure all the data is in cache. Okay. What data primarily? The seed time, till what time this video has been watched. Next, chunk ID for this video, frame rate, what has been adapted by this service, the resolution, playback speed, and subtitle. This is the data primarily we can keep in cache, and we can serve all the metadata from Metadata DB. And once we serve the metadata, the browser would be able to pull the chunk from CDN itself. Okay. So this is how the video serving happens. Okay. Now let's talk about what happens if a user comes on homepage. Okay. The idea is to show trending videos primarily. Also, users' watch history. Okay, so homepage service can maintain platform level trending videos in cache and device specific videos of his interest based on watch history on device. And in order to populate similar videos for his watch history, primarily the last video title or description could be fed into video search service and we can figure out what are related items. And that is how homepage service is populating all the watch history related videos in the cache. Okay. Now question comes, how homepage service is populating trending videos? For this, we need to push some watch stats from the user side. Okay. For that, we will have one more service where we are streaming all the stats from the browser side to this service. Basically, this service is responsible for capturing stats while watching a video, and this service would be pushing this to homepage service again, so that homepage service can make use of this data in order to populate similar videos in cache. So whenever user comes on a home page, he can see trending videos and similar videos based on his local device watch history. Okay. And this is how so far the system works. There's one more thing. What happens when seek time gets updated on one device? Obviously, we would be updating this time in cache, but until unless we refresh the browser on the second device or we refresh the app client on the second device, we wouldn't be able to update the seek time on devices, right? In order to do that automatically, we can do one thing. Whenever user starts watching a video, we will keep updating seek time in cache. Also, we will keep pushing this seek time into seek update message queue, from where notified devices service, a notification service, can notify all different browsers and clients accordingly to update the seek time. So this is how, so far, we have designed this system. Okay, let me know your feedback. Also, please like, share, and subscribe. Thanks.